The ocean is the engine that drives our climate system, storing tremendous heat and moving energy around the globe. To deepen their understanding of how these systems work and respond to global change, oceanographers need ships, floating laboratories that give them access to this vast reservoir of information.
You do have people that use these giant climate models and ocean models, but without data to validate them, they'd be guesses.
A lot of the satellite work can only see down at just sometimes just a few millimeters below the surface. So you really have to be on a boat to make measurements within the ocean interior.
There are still things, and I think there will always be things that we can only measure from ships. For me, I can't take a little copepod from the ocean and do an experiment sitting in my office. I need to be out there on a ship.
Research vessels live out their intended life cycle and eventually must be replaced. As new technologies emerge, and as the needs of the scientific community change, alongside the very ocean they seek to understand. The National Science Foundation set out to meet these growing demands, funding the design and construction of three ships to forge the future of ocean science.
We need vessels with all kinds of capabilities to reach all of the world's oceans for the different research topics. The regional class research vessels, like the three we're constructing now, are intended primarily for coastal environments, the continental slope, the continental shelf, and we're building three so we can support oceanography needs on each of the three main U.S. coasts, west, east, and Gulf of Mexico.
The regional class research vessels are intended to focus on coastal ocean research. And there's really never been a more critical time for that. Climate change is real. Climate change is being caused by the buildup of carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. This is warming the planet, it's warming the oceans. If we would like to be able to understand this, predict the trajectory of change, there's never been a more important time to study the oceans.
Each major U.S. coast will host one of these ships. Oregon State University will operate the first ship out of Newport, Oregon, with research spanning the entire West Coast up into Alaska. The second will be managed by the East Coast Oceanographic Consortium, led by the University of Rhode Island. And the final ship will be managed by the Gulf Caribbean Oceanographic Consortium, jointly led by the University of Southern Mississippi and the Louisiana University's Marine Consortium.
We do have a fleet of vessels that is available to all the researchers in the U.S., even though you don't have to work at one of the institutions that's the operator. If you get funded to go, then it's the operator's job to support that research.
The United States academic fleet plans for decades ahead, renewing vessels not only to meet the current needs of the science community, but also to anticipate for the future.
The U.S. academic research fleet, meaning the ships that are available to do science on, are managed by a consortium called the University National Oceanographic Laboratory System. And that's a group of organizations comprising academic institutions that help make these resources available to scientists all over the country.
And so UNE also is created to coordinate and make it a fleet that's available to the academic community. And they work with the federal agencies to ensure that the right kind of support is coming in, the right kind of instrumentation is on the ship. And UNALS also projects to the future. So we'll have ships that are reaching their lifetime, which might be 40 years or so. And we need to be thinking about replacing those ships.
The current research vessel fleet that we have in the Gulf of Mexico is aging like it is in the rest of the country, and we were running into the real possibility that we were going to be without that capacity any longer at a time, after the oil spill and hurricanes and all these things that had happened in recent history. We knew that there was going to be enough work in the future for this regional class vessel in probably the hardest working region of the United States.
There's really an increasing emphasis on research in our coastal oceans because they are facing some serious problems, and we need ships to go out and sample to be able to study those problems.
The oceanographic research community in the U.S. has been talking about the need for these vessels for decades.
We had a conceptual design for regional class ships that needed to be what we call refreshed.
Oregon State University met the requirements for leading such an effort, and we were selected by the National Science Foundation in 2012 and began the project in 2013.
The National Science Foundation operates on a community-driven basis, and so these were born out of this community.
Keeping our fleet current is really important for the competitiveness of U.S. science. It's also important to modernize the fleet because we want to practice what we preach, and modern vessels are a lot more environmentally friendly. They're much more fuel efficient, and so that's a really important part of keeping the fleet current.
We have those technologies now. They have to be married with a ship that can use them and use them to their fullest purposes. And when those two things come together, the pace of scientific discovery is going to explode. And we expect that to fully happen from all three of the regional class vessels that are being built.
For these regional class research vessels, it'll give us a lot of opportunities to go out to the ocean and train the students, because they're next generation scientists. Then they need the platform to get trained to understand the ocean and understand oceanography and marine science. So that is important.
The future of ocean science in the United States depends on a vastly improved research fleet. With these three ships, we will be able to tackle some of the most pressing issues facing our planet today.
The RCRVs are critical for this. State of the art, they're opening up the opportunities to people that have never really had access to the ocean. There's a whole cohort of students coming up behind us, trained in ocean systems, trained in the issues that our future generations are being faced with. Let's look for those solutions and progress into the future in a positive way.